Do you always want to be an artist?
Yep, that's all I could ever do. Don't give me mathematics.
And talk about some of this. If you want to talk about this one, or I mean, we'll cut it here. But you want to like tell us, you know, what one of these mean, or what it means to you, what you see when you look at it.
Well, the colours, you know, are very strong, powerful colours. So we're working in primary colours with this painting, and the essence of it is the shape, and the shapes are, believe it or not, derived from landscape in the first place. But then you start to see sensuality, the meaning of life, and it's like one shape leading into another. It's like creation itself. But I did not have the imagination I have now. And it's come through years and years of painting, as I said before, coming out with your own, seeing symbols in your own work, and then pulling them out and turning these into abstract paintings. And more these paintings have grown. And just fairly recently, I've come to this scale where I feel as though I need to, my mind can no longer just go from the wrist or the arm. I feel as though I've got to go the whole body. So my mind and my body are one, working across the whole surface. And that's why I have it on the floor, because I actually walk across my work while I'm painting it. Yeah, well, I was written up here so often as being a Jackson Pollock in the way that I paint, because I throw paint at the surface, and I pour paint on, and, you know, I brush it on. I mean, I do more techniques than Pollock did. I use every technique you can think of, from rolling paint on, from brushing it on, to designing where I'm going to put things, you know. He didn't do any of that. He just chucked everything at it, including his cigarettes and beer. So if he can do that and his paintings can be worth over $10 million, I reckon I can do it too. I've got more things going. Yeah.
Thank you so much for sharing your powerful work with us. It's beautiful.
Okay, well, that's beautiful having you here.